So right here we have last year's iPhone 10 and the brand new iPhone XS Max, which has the same camera as the iPhone XS. So let's snap some photos and see how big of a difference there truly is.
Starting off with a selfie photo, the iPhone 10 does surprisingly well, but the XS Max still has better dynamic range and more detail, as you can see on the vest. Both phones do very well, but we like the white balance of the iPhone 10 a little bit better. Now taking a photo against the sun, the iPhone XS Max has much better dynamic range. There's an even bigger difference when you try to take a portrait photo against the sun. The face is extremely underexposed with the iPhone 10. In this photo, both phones do very well at dynamic range. However, you can see that the XS Max has a wider lens than the iPhone 10. Now let's compare portrait mode. You can see that the shirt and arms are better exposed on the iPhone XS Max, thanks to the new Smart HDR feature. Now the awesome thing about the iPhone XS and XS Max is that now you can control the depth. Now here it is at f1.4, the highest level of blur you can get. And I've gotta admit, it looks really nice compared to the iPhone X's photo. Now let me show you how adjusting the depth looks like on the iPhone XS Max. The lowest amount of depth is now f16, and you can go all the way up to f1.4. You have a much wider range of depth control compared to other devices like the Note 9. Here's that same image at the default level of depth, and here it is at f1.4. Here's another example of how depth control on the iPhone XS and XS Max can really transform a photo. We snapped this photo in some pretty harsh conditions, and as you can see, the XS Max completely destroys the iPhone 10 in terms of dynamic range. And here it is on the iPhone XS Max at f1.4. It makes it look so much better. Now this is actually the minimal range at which you can take a portrait photo. In this case, f1.4 starts to look a bit unnatural. Now here's a selfie portrait photo. What's great about the iPhone XS and XS Max is that you can actually turn up the depth on the selfie side as well, and the result actually ends up looking really nice. Now here's a photo in low light. As you can see, the colors really pop on the XS Max. And when you turn up the blur on the XS Max, the bokeh actually warps and rotates directionally, just like a real lens does. Now here's an autofocus comparison. You might not be able to tell what's going on, but let me slow it down. I freeze the frame right here, and what the iPhone X is actually doing is hunting for focus. And when it comes back to the face, the iPhone X has an issue of underexposing before bringing it back up. The XS Max doesn't have any of these issues. You can actually see how blue the sky is. On the iPhone X, it's all white and blown out. Now let's compare detail without portrait mode. The XS Max looks a little bit flat compared to the iPhone X, which has more contrast. And it's the same story for this photo. The iPhone X's extra contrast makes it look a lot better. In this close-up, the XS Max's white balance is worlds better. And if you look closely, it's got much more detail than the iPhone X. Here, we see much better colors on the XS Max, both in the flowers and in the sky. In this wide detail shot, the XS Max looks a little bit more detailed. And the story is the same for the telephoto lens. Just compare the detail for yourself by looking at that bush. In this regular selfie photo, both phones do great at dynamic range. However, the iPhone XS Max's photo is much more detailed. Now let's move on to low light. As you can see, the dynamic range on the XS Max is worlds better than the iPhone X. Both the painting and the lamp is extremely overexposed. And the iPhone X added a little bit too much softening. Just look at the pants. Now with the telephoto lens, we see the exact same results, both in dynamic range and softness of the iPhone X. This photo shows a massive difference in dynamic range. So much of the iPhone X's image is completely blown out. This photo was shot in extremely low light. The XS Max actually does better with noise reduction, and you can see a lot more detail as well. Now here's a shot we took towards the end of the evening. You can easily tell that the XS Max has much better dynamic range. And the story is the same for this photo. You can see a huge difference in dynamic range by looking at the building on the right side of the frame. Finally, let's finish it off with a low light portrait photo. Both images look equally detailed, but the tree in the background looks quite a bit overexposed on the iPhone X. After adjusting the depth on the XS Max to f1.4, the bokeh looks great. However, any issues with blur edging is now much more noticeable. Thanks for watching, guys, and make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on more videos like this one. And let us know what you thought about this comparison in the comment section below.
If you enjoyed this video, like it and hit that subscribe button. Also, check out our price guide, which makes it extremely easy to find the best deals on Apple products updated daily. Be sure to follow us on social media, and we'll see you in the next video.